Hello everybody, today we're walking through the Throttle Wizard for the Skookum Robotics SK720. This is the fourth and final wizard, and we'll also cover the fail-safe system as well. Our Protos 500 has the SK720 mounted under the main gear. We've mounted the center servo in front of the left and right servos, and our 120-degree swashplate is set up accordingly. Our SK720 has the servo bus mounted left for easy access to the USB port and servo bus. Before you get started, it's important to make sure that your motor is disabled. On our electric heli, I've disconnected two of the three motor wires. I'll also note that the throttle is disabled for safety in setup mode, except when using the nitro governor mode. The SK720 has a built-in governor. However, it's not essential for it to be activated if you're using an electric motor. We're going to leave the governor off today, and for instructions on tips for setting it up, you can watch our governor video later. Once you've finished your governor settings, you can disconnect your SK720 from your PC and connect your throttle servo or ESC into the throttle or input-output A port. This is labeled as IOAT on the SK720. Once you've connected your throttle servo or ESC, you'll need to set the throttle endpoints on your transmitter. On an ESC, like we've got on our heli, it's best to set your throttle travel to 100%. If you're using a nitro heli, set the travel so your engine's throttle opens and closes in each direction without binding. After that, you need to set your throttle hold position. On an electric heli, you want to set your hold low enough that the motor shuts off, while on a nitro engine, set a steady idle. If you need instructions on how to set up your transmitter, you can watch our transmitter-specific video. Now that the transmitter is properly set up, it's time to reconnect your unit to the PC. Shortly after reconnecting, values for the throttle and control stick will appear in the highlighted area. Next, it's time to set your helicopter's idle and max throttle positions. First, turn on your transmitter's throttle hold, then click the Set Idle Throttle button. In the next step, select the Idle Up To setting on your transmitter and click the highlighted Set Max Throttle button. This is the last step in the throttle wizard. Before we finish though, we're going to set our fail-safe control positions. This function isn't in any of the wizards, but it's a good precaution to take in case you lose your radio link. First, turn on your transmitter while your SK720 is connected to your PC, and make sure that the interface is showing your control inputs. Next, set your collective stick to a few degrees of negative pitch. This will allow the heli to auto-rotate if the connection is lost. Once you've done this, go to the Utility menu and select Set Failsafe Control Positions. The SK720 will remember your pitch settings and apply them if it ever loses the transmitter signal. You don't need to worry about throttle, the failsafe automatically sets it to zero. That's the end of the throttle setup and the end of our setup wizard videos. As always, you can find more troubleshooting info on the wiki at skookumrobotics.com or on the other videos in this series. Thanks for watching and happy flying!